Hi friends, glad to see you all. I suggest that you familiarize yourself with the next topic of the training cycle, Arduino Lessons Arrays. Without the help of arrays, many tasks and widely known algorithms would be incredibly difficult to implement in program code. This is a really important part of probably every programming language. Arrays can be one-dimensional or multidimensional. We will consider multidimensional ones in the next lesson. Arrays help to optimize the code, significantly reduce the number of its lines. Also, in addition to being useful, sometimes arrays can also carry the danger of a controller freezing. Watch the video up to the end and I'll show you how to avoid nasty situations when using arrays in a program that the Arduino compiler is unable to detect as a bug. In the meantime, you can subscribe to the channel and share the link to the video with a friend and continue. An array is a data type that is an ordered set of elements of the same type, sequentially located in the controller's memory, which have their own index or a series of indexes. Unlike ordinary variables, which store a single value, arrays are needed to store a number of values of the same type. Same type means having one simple type, byte or int or char or others. For example, if you created an array of elements of the byte type, then you cannot write an integer less than 0 or more than 255 into any cell from it. Arrays with one index are called one-dimensional, with two, two-dimensional, and so on. Most often, programmers use one-dimensional and two-dimensional arrays, less often three-dimensional ones. An array can be represented as a table of values of any parameters. For a one-dimensional array, that is, an array with one index, it will look like this. In the first table, the representation of an array of elements of the byte type, and in the second, an array of the string type. The first column contains the indexes of the array elements, and the second column contains the values of the elements. Indexes in Arduino are integer only and always start from zero. And the number of indexes or elements of a particular array is set in the program once during its declaration. A one-dimensional array is declared in the same way as other variables, by specifying the data type of the elements and the name of the array, plus square brackets. Everything before the square brackets is a simple variable declaration. The maximum number of elements is indicated in parentheses. Let's talk again for understanding and remembering. To define an array in the Arduino IDE program, you must specify the type of its elements, the name and the maximum number of these elements. And the maximum number of elements is the size of the array. You can also specify the size of an array using a named constant. This is useful if you have many arrays of the same size. Then their size can be set and changed in the process of setting up the program simply by replacing one digit assigned to the literal constant at the beginning of the sketch. In the third option, the example shows that the size in square brackets can be either specified or not specified if you immediately initialize or assign initial values to all elements of the array. Then the compiler will automatically determine the size of the array and the memory required to store it. Here, the two options will be equally processed by the Arduino IDE compiler. And this example shows three equivalent ways to create an array with four elements and given the initial values of the elements. Below is a tabular representation of the created array. For global arrays that are declared at the beginning of the sketch before the setup function, the dimension in square brackets can only be set by a constant. And for local arrays, that is, those that are used only inside the function, the dimension can also be set to a variable. It must be an integer variable. If you like these tutorials, then click the subscribe button and share the link to the video on social networks. But what will happen if the dimension of the array in square brackets is greater than the given initial values? That's right, an array will be created with the number of elements specified in square brackets. But in the remaining unspecified last cells, a zero value will be written. Remember that array cell values are not automatically filled with zeros. For this to happen, at least one element must be filled. For example, if from the very beginning you need to write zeros to all cells of an array, then you should declare it in the program with 10 in curly brackets. After declaring an array, further in the program you can change the values of its cells by simple assignment. As with a regular variable, but with an index in square brackets. The numbering of array indexes starts from 0, and this is not always convenient. If you don't want to count any elements of your algorithm from scratch in the program using arrays, and the controller has enough free memory, then you can simply create arrays with a dimension 1 more than necessary and start counting from the first index. And the zero element of the array will simply not be used in the program. You can also read the values of array cells exactly like simple variables, but with the index in square brackets. Also, for individual array elements, indexes can be set by variables. Here, by the way, frequent problems are hidden when debugging Arduino programs. After all, if a number greater than the dimension of the array is written to the variable that specifies the element index, then most likely the controller will fail and even freeze. This happened to me often. In this case, the compiler will not see your error and the buggy program can be safely loaded into the controller. Then it is very difficult to trace the glitch. So be careful with array indexes. The output of array cell values to the port monitor also differs little from simple variables. To output all cells to the port monitor, there are no standard functions in the Arduino IDE, but you can create your own. Arrays in the Arduino platform are used in many tasks. For example, to cycle through rows or data tables. Thus, they are used in search and other algorithms. Here, in the example, using the for loop, all 5 elements of the array are sorted out and, one by one, their values are printed to the port monitor. Arrays are also used for primitive work with objects of the same type. For example, if you need to create variables for program work with 3 functionally identical engines. The array I here stores the currents through the 3 motors. The array W stores the revolutions of each of the 3 engines. This representation of the data makes it possible to calculate these currents in a loop, facilitating setup and reducing the size of the program. Loops are also great for numbered grouping of text data. For example, when processing the user's menu, it is convenient to create and use an array of elements of the string type in the program. And then call the names of menu items in the program, using array elements, by integer indices. In this lesson, we have thoroughly pumped our knowledge of one-dimensional arrays in the Arduino platform. And in the next lesson, we will consider working with multidimensional arrays, which you should also meet when solving some problems and reading other people's ready-made programs. Now do not forget to check that you are subscribed to the channel, write comments and share the link to the video with your friends. With that, I say goodbye and see you soon.